To understand some of these highlights better, still with me in the new studio is Gautam Chikharmani, who is the Vice President of the Observer Research Foundation. Gautam, thanks so much for staying with us. Now, let's talk about some of the big hits and misses of the Union Budget, according to you.
Yeah, so it's still a work in progress. I'm still reading it. But the more I'm reading, I think the big story is clearly infrastructure.
Right.
And within infrastructure, capital spending on infrastructure.
Mm-hmm.
This was expected, this was needed, and this will ignite further investments.
Mm-hmm.
And I hope it will turn into a virtuous cycle of mm-hmm. investments, growth, jobs. For instance, this infrastructure is going to see a 35% increase in mm-hmm. expenditure to 5.5 lakh crore. I think that's a big number.
Right.
It's much required. Then within that, there are things like asset monetization, where mm-hmm. The government plans to monetize roads, airports, mm-hmm. railways, dedicated freight corridors,
mm-hmm.
and in order to raise money mm-hmm. For the other. So infrastructure to me is the biggest story mm-hmm. so far. Then there is an asset reconstruction company. There's a talk about an asset reconstruction company which will take on the bad debts, the bad assets of various
mm-hmm.
banks, put it together and sell them off, securitize them perhaps, or sell mm-hmm. them off in strategic sales. I think this will ease the pressure on banking, mm-hmm. which is another required thing.
Right.
In terms of misses, I still need to read it carefully,
mm-hmm.
but I think this increasing FDI in insurance to 74%, it's a good thing.
Right.
Make it 100% for all I care. But the actual reform and what is required in insurance
mm-hmm.
is a reform of the regulator, which is Insurance Regulatory Development Authority, and the companies within
mm-hmm.
it. I think insurance sector is somehow evading surveillance
mm-hmm.
by the government, by taxpayers, by citizens, and it has been institutionalized into what can be called anti-consumer regulator.
Mm-hmm.
Neither does it give data, nor is mm-hmm. nor are consumers given the return that they
mm-hmm.
get. For some reason, the government after government, this is
mm-hmm.
nothing to do with this budget or with this government,
right.
but government after government has been unwilling to or unable to reform
mm-hmm.
insurance in the manner that it ought to be, which is make it consumer facing. The way,
right.
for instance, Securities and Exchange Board of India has reformed mutual funds. That's a truly a transparent area. So every time it is said that increasing FDI, it used to be 26%
mm-hmm.
and we made it 49, now it's going to go to 74. It will deliver greater penetration into the market. That not happened. The insurance companies are still in,
right.
in the metros. It will give better services. That has not happened.
Mm-hmm.
It will give more products. That has happened.
Mm-hmm.
But at what cost? And how many of, for instance, in health insurance, consumers are constantly facing problems, more so during the COVID
right.
time, in terms of getting money from the insurance company. So I think the increasing insurance to 74% is another tick box.
Right.
But I don't think the government is ready to or
mm-hmm.
or wanting to, or maybe it's ignorant of
mm-hmm.
The real problems in the insurance sector.
Mm-hmm.
You clearly need to fix this.
Mm-hmm.
The second thing which I find like a return to the past, and it's a needless thing, is the setting up of another development finance institution. I don't know why this is happening, why it is required, because we had development finance institutions. We had IFCI in 1948. In 1955, ICICI came.
Mm-hmm.
And in 1964, we had IDBI.
Mm-hmm.
They've all become banks.
Right.
So if development finance is not a sustainable business or a sustainable organization, and it has failed and everybody has become
mm-hmm.
a bank, why would you now create this out of the blue? And I think it may sound very good that it will focus the energies of the institution
mm-hmm.
towards, let us say, development,
right.
economics, towards infrastructure
mm-hmm.
and so on. But it's a failed organization. It's
mm-hmm.
a failed model.
Mm-hmm.
I think we can look at better things,
mm-hmm.
a greater securitization. Now the government can raise money directly from people.
Mm-hmm.
For instance, if you start a deep discount bond, for instance.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know why this has come, where
mm-hmm.
this will go, but this looks like going back to Nehru and Indira Gandhi
mm-hmm.
days,
mm-hmm.
and I don't see any reason for it.
Mm-hmm. All right, Gautam, thanks for that. We'll continue our discussion shortly. For now, let's go over to our business editor, Sumit Chaturvedi, for an insight into how the markets are faring at this point.
Well, Priyanka, Thanks for having me. Here, markets are really, really giving a big thumbs up to today's budget. Sensex, as we speak, has gone up by 2,000 points since morning, when clearly we can say that bulls are back into the Indian markets once again. It's clearly something they were expecting, so the markets were building up since today morning. And these announcements, they have given more boost to markets. One big positive for markets is that absence of any hike in big corporate taxes. We were hearing, or there were rumors in the markets, that there could be more Corona cess or more corporate tax could be there. Well, that has not come, and that is something giving a big boost to Indian markets. Sensex 50 both up at this moment. Also, what government did not do is to touch the dividend distribution tax or any other long-term capital gain tax. So in a way, the markets were afraid that they will be finally paying for growth of the economy. That didn't happen, and that's one big positive that is clearly giving big boost to markets. Also, other global markets since morning are in green only. That is another big boost to markets. So clearly, overall, we can say that bulls are ruling the Indian markets once again. Today's announcements, especially when it comes to infrastructure, it comes to overall rural economy, overall spending big on healthcare scheme. This has given big boost to economy. Yes, agri says infra cess is there, and it is to be seen on what all items agri infra cess will be there. But as we speak, clearly markets are in a very good mood right now. Sensex up by more than 2,000 points as we speak. Since the morning, they were up by 500 points. Another factor this week we will be looking forward to is RBI's meeting on Friday. Well, that is something we have to look forward to. But overall, as we see from March last year, when the markets came down heavily and Sensex was at 25,000 levels, mm-hmm. to this month when it finally touched 50,000 mark, it's clearly a big boost for markets, and we can say that overall bulls are back in Indian markets.
Right. Now, Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman also announced further recapitalization of rupees 20,000 crore for the public sector banks to clean up the non-performing assets in the banking sector. Asset reconstruction company and asset management companies will be created, and these companies will take over the stressed assets and sell to alternative investment funds. The measures will help to improve the health of the banking sector. The initial public offering of Life Insurance Corporation of India will be out in financial year 2022. Legislative amendments to this effect will be launched in the Parliament in the budget session. Listen in.
The high level of provisioning by public sector banks of their stressed assets calls for a measure to clean up the bank books. An asset reconstruction company limited and asset management company would be set up to consolidate and take over the existing stressed debt and then manage and dispose of the assets to alternative investment funds and other potential investors for eventual value realization. Recapitalization of PSB. To further consolidate the financial capital capacity of PSBs, further recapitalization of 20,000 crores is proposed in 21-22. Deposit insurance. Last year,
breaking all traditions, the Finance Minister of India, Nirmala Sitharaman, ditched the Bahi Khata on the budget day and switched to a Made in India tablet. For the budget presentation each year, the Finance Ministers were always seen carrying a briefcase to the Parliament. Moving forward with the time, the current Finance Minister switched to a tablet, making the budget of 2021 entirely paperless. Now, this is the first time in the history of modern India that a budget was presented through a tablet, and soft copies of the budget were provided to all members of the Parliament. Enabled hassle-free access to budget documents by the MPs and the general public using the simplest form of digital convenience. The decision to go paperless this year was also due to the ongoing coronavirus pandemic. The budget was surely unlike any other, as it reinforced the Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi's Digital India and Make in India missions. Now, still with us on this broadcast is Gautam Chikarmani from the Observer Research Foundation. Gautam, my question to you, tell us about the markets and how they are performing today. Explain to us, why are they rising?
I think if I could explain markets to you, I wouldn't be sitting here. I would be sitting next to Warren Buffett, perhaps. But let me give it a shot. I think in the in the last year, which is 2020, companies tightened their expenses. Mm-hmm. Some people were let go. Real estate was let go. And there was a general efficiency that had come into the corporate system, mm-hmm. which Sensex is generally large right. corporates. And all that has helped sort of cut costs. Mm-hmm. At the same time now, in the expectation of revival, we saw the Sensex touch 50,000 a couple of weeks ago. Why it has risen by 2,000 points as we talk, and mm-hmm. we don't know where this will end, is, in my opinion, I think the first thing is that the fiscal deficit has been lower than what was expected. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I think the markets, well, I don't know about the markets. I certainly expected a higher fiscal mm-hmm. deficit, and perhaps right. the markets too. Now that it is only 6.8%, it is perhaps good mm-hmm. that the fiscal deficit is now, the fiscal finances of the government are under control despite such bad times. The second thing I feel is that there is a sharp thrust and an open thrust mm-hmm. on infrastructure. 35% increase to 5 lakh crore. Mm-hmm. I think that's very big. Mm-hmm. It is big also because this is the time that the government is showing that we are willing to spend mm-hmm. to create infrastructure upon which the next level of growth will happen and upon which the other companies mm-hmm. after a quarter or two will ride. Mm-hmm. So in anticipation of that ride, and maybe companies will do it faster. Mm-hmm. And my sense is they will do it within this quarter, but I'm just hedging myself here. Mm-hmm. So the government spending on infrastructure has begun, upon which private companies will rise, mm-hmm. due to which profits may rise, and therefore the markets are mm-hmm. increasing. The overall, I think when you look at markets, we should not take the short-term movements too seriously.
Right.
I think markets work on the in the long term. Mm-hmm. You talk about 5 years, 10 years, 30 years. And that's when markets, mm-hmm. as far as consumers are concerned, investors, mm-hmm. small investors are concerned, give you the kind of returns that they do. Mm-hmm. In this particular case, I think it is clearly infrastructure and fiscal deficit.
Right. Right. Gautam, let's talk about corporate India. Anything significant in the budget for India's MNCs?
I think tax rates have remained the same, mm-hmm. which he had mm-hmm. done earlier. Mm-hmm. So nothing specific mm-hmm. has come, mm-hmm. except that during this bad time, no new taxes have been placed. Mm-hmm. In mm-hmm. fact, maybe because there is no, everybody expected perhaps, mm-hmm. where will the money come from? Mm-hmm. And they would increase the taxes. The fact right. that she hasn't done so is maybe also a relief why the markets are up. Mm-hmm. So I don't know. I think companies, the ball is now clearly with the companies. The government right. has done what it has had
right.
to do.
Right.
Now it's up to entrepreneurs to get mm-hmm. their act together and start building, start making, mm-hmm. delivering services. If at all anything that what we would expect from the government is that it should get the regulatory cholesterol mm-hmm. out of the way over the next mm-hmm. Few months, right. maybe even the next 12 months. Regulatory mm-hmm. cholesterol in the sense that there are 1,500 laws that mm-hmm. govern doing business mm-hmm. in India. There are 70,000 compliances mm-hmm. at an aggregate that companies need to deliver. Mm-hmm. There are 6,600 filings mm-hmm. that companies need to do. Each filing has a whole lot of paperwork behind mm-hmm. it, whole lot of information, data collection, mm-hmm. and various avenues for rent seeking. Mm-hmm. If the government can start clearing this part, mm-hmm. so taking the budget as a precursor to investment mm-hmm. and investments being catalyzed by a further mm-hmm. reduction or mm-hmm. ending mm-hmm. of regulatory infrastructure, regulatory cholesterol, mm-hmm. then I think the companies will, the India story will ride faster than the 11.5%
right.
that IMF is talking
right.
about.
All right, Gautam, thank you so much for all your insights on the budget and for helping us decode this budget to a large extent. And
co-presented by Skoda, simply clever.
VEON World is One is now available in your country. Download the app now and get all the news updates on the move.